Some good news for commuters. The Philippine National Railways has resumed its train services to and from Naga, Camarines Sur and Legazpi Albay after a six-year hiatus. The PNR says there would be four trips daily. Fares start at 15 pesos and go up to 155 pesos for travelers heading to the route's last stop. Operations were suspended last April 2017 due to a lack of train coaches and locomotives. Philippine state universities and colleges will be required to increase the number of admission slots they award to students from poor families in 2024. The chief of the Commission on Higher Education, Prospero De Vera, says this is part of the country's push for more equitable tertiary education.
Kailangan tutukan na yung inclusive education. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng public university should re-examine their admission policy and slowly increase the percentage and number of students admitted from poor families. Once na nakapasok, tututukan natin na sila'y makapagtapos.
De Vera adds the government also wants to establish at least four additional medical schools next year. This as the Philippines aspires to continue producing world-class doctors and nurses. While De Vera did not mention the locations of the proposed medical schools, he notes tuition will be shouldered by the government. The number of firecracker-related injuries in the Philippines has risen to 75. That's after the Philippine Health Department recorded 23 new cases from December 26 to 27, most of which were due to illegal fireworks. Six cases led to amputations. Meanwhile, the Philippine Trade Department reminds the public to check the authenticity of safety seals on fireworks or firecrackers they are purchasing. This after the department confiscated over 1,500 illegal products in Bulacan last week. Assistant Secretary Amada Nograles says manufacturers could face a 300,000 peso fine if caught selling illegal firecrackers.
Kada manufacturer na merong lisensya, meron lang specific models na pwede silang i-manufacture at ibenta. Mas maganda po i-check natin yung ano yung bawal ng PNP at saka kung ano yung pinayagan ng DTI. Kailangan balik-balikan po natin yung listahan.
A Philippine senator says President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s travel fund allocation for next year reflects his administration's priorities. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel made that remark in response to reports Marcos's travel budget for 2024 was increased by 58% to 1.4 billion pesos. Pimentel tells the Marcos administration the Filipino people's problems may be more local than they think. According to the Philippine Trade Department, Marcos's foreign trips this year have brought in nearly 300 million or 300 billion pesos in investments to the country.
India is deploying guided missile destroyer ships in the Arabian Sea following a suspected drone attack on an Israel-affiliated merchant vessel of the Indian coast. No one was hurt in the attack on the vessel MV Camp Pluto over the weekend. The ship was carrying 21 Indians and a Vietnamese national as crew members. The Indian Navy says it is committed to keeping sea lanes in the Indian Ocean region safe and secure for maritime trade. Iran calls as baseless accusations made by the Pentagon that it was involved in the attack.
Even as we speak, we have four destroyers of 15 Alpha and Bravo class deployed to counter piracy and drone attacks on merchant shipping.